Hello, guys. Welcome in here back to another edition. I have changed the name of my show from Rover Sports. It's now called The Analyzation of Sports. It's kind of like a bridge name for me. I might be like adding certain people to the channel. They might have the ability to make certain videos because I want to be a part of a bigger team than just myself. That's kind of the purpose of this channel. You know, it's enough stress kind of, rolling with the channel individually. But I like constant changing of the name, and it kind of keeps me on my toes and maybe the audience as well. And it's just something that I like to do. And I know that's kind of unique to the YouTube game. But listen, I'm excited. I'm going to be able now to post more content on so many different elements of football now that I've changed my name of this YouTube channel. So I think that this will maybe unlock more potential subjects from being discussed by myself on this channel. So I'm really anxious to kind of begin this journey and pretty much record a lot of different shows on a variety of different topics pertaining to the National Football League and also pertaining to college football as well as high school football. So really diving in deep to, you know, what these things represent more than the surface level. And I'm here to talk about Mac Jones, okay? So Mac Jones, he didn't get drafted by San Francisco. Their fans would have panicked because they're like, this is a fat and a slow quarterback. That's why they would have panicked, because they look at the NFL and the Niners fans see Lamar Jackson that can run the football, that can run it outside of the pocket. They see a Josh Allen. They see Justin Herbert that can improvise on the run and make throws. And they look at Mac Jones and they see a weaker-armed quarterback that has no mobility skills. And they look at Fields and Lance better because at the pro day, those guys did better, when really a lot of the 49ers fans were not even following Alabama football because it's in the Southeastern Conference. So the point is, with Mac Jones developing in the NFL, I believe that even if he went to San Francisco, he was going to be good. And I don't want to hear the reason that Mac Jones is very good is because of Bill Belichick and his brilliance. Because you saw Cam Newton last year, and Cam Newton was not very successful in this offense, okay? Matt Castle was decent, but come on. I mean, if Mac Jones is going to be really good with this team, you got to give credit to the player. And just like the Brady versus Belichick debate, if you don't give Tom Brady credit for winning these championships, then I think that you're just a guy that really despises Tom Brady. If you're going to give credit the entire way, either to Tom or Bill Belichick, I think that they both factor in. I think that they're both incredibly important and valuable. And obviously, Tom Brady went down to Tampa and he changed the culture almost single-handedly and changed the expectation. So I believe that Mac Jones for the 49ers, I think that Mac Jones is going to be a better quarterback than Trey Lance. I'm going to say that right here on this video. I think that Mac Jones is going to win more. Now, will Trey Lance be a guy that puts up more statistics than Mac Jones? It very well could be possible. Who has a higher ceiling as a singular player? It is Trey Lance. So I kind of understand the pick. Now, who's a little bit more risky? I think it could be Trey Lance, because Trey Lance, can he pepper the ball in the middle of the field? You know, can he throw with different trajectories? Trey Lance, I mean, with Mac Jones, you have so much intel. You know, you have Saban, you have Alabama, you have 4 years, 5 years. The guy's like 23, 24 years old. Trey Lance can't even drink yet. You don't even know. He's not even 21 years old, so you don't even really know. You know, the guy is just, he played 1 year of football. He's from a small town in Minnesota. He's probably, again, he is just from Minnesota. You don't have a lot of exposure to a lot of guys that know this guy. The guy is from Marshall, Minnesota. A very small town. He played at an FCS level college for 1 year, and he played on the best team in all of college football in North Dakota State. That's probably won about 10 or 12 championships. You have the best facilities, you have the best running backs, and you're also from Marshall and from these other universities, you're not playing against elite level cornerbacks and elite level defensive backs really in the FCS, in the Missouri Valley Conference, where North Dakota State plays. So they, you look at the 49ers fans, and they didn't want a guy that wouldn't be able to get outside the pocket, and they're just going to compare Mac Jones to Jimmy Garoppolo. Well, Mac Jones has a lot stronger arm than Jimmy Garoppolo. Mac Jones is more intelligent, I think, at dissecting plays. I think that Mac Jones also has a quick release, and I also think Mac Jones' footwork in the pocket, I think that he is nimble enough, being a tennis player and being a good athlete. I think that he's plenty athletic enough that he can be a really, really successful quarterback, and that he can dice up and be an explosive quarterback. Because if he wasn't an explosive quarterback, then at college that offense wouldn't have popped. He's also 6'3", has a big arm, and is a big kid. So, I mean, that stuff helps, but he's also mobile enough, has a shorter release, and his intangibles are next level great. Now, will his intangibles make up for the lack of speed that he has? That's possible. Is the NFL defensive ends going to get to Mac Jones and going to put him on the ground? Now, for Mac Jones, it's so important that his quick release, that he's so decisive with his quick release. But I think that Mac Jones is a special worker. He has special intangible values. I think that his release is fast enough. I think his arm strength is good enough to be a really great quarterback. He just checks every single box, and he's the ultimate leader. I mean, people are going to point to his DUI that he had when he was 18 years old, and that's very understandable. Now, that is 5 years ago. If it happened the time when the draft was coming up, I think that would even be more concerning, but sometimes time can heal. So you look at Mac Jones and for that instance, and it is tough when you're the star quarterback at Bulls High School to then be a third stringer on the practice squad, and your motivation could go haywire, kind of like Johnny Manziel in Cleveland when Mike Pettine wouldn't play Johnny football at all, wouldn't let him get into a rhythm, wouldn't let him see the field, wouldn't let him feel what it was like to be an NFL quarterback, wouldn't throw him to the wolves. And it was so frustrating because his career ended up dying anyway, but they didn't allow the kid to go in and try to go in and play the game of football. And that was infuriating to watch. So I'm really excited about Mac Jones in New England. I believe Mac Jones can compete for championships. And then if Mac Jones wins championships, they're going to say that his defense carried him, that the running game carried him, that Bill Belichick carried him. So really for Mac Jones, the people that don't like Mac Jones are just going to always credit Bill Belichick. But I'm here to say that Mac Jones is the 15th pick. If he ever wins a Super Bowl, it's a massive success from a guy that was drafted as the fifth overall quarterback in his draft class. I think Mac will definitely be better than Fields. I mean, Trey Lance has a chance to be fantastic. I think Zach Wilson also, he's not going to a great situation, but Zach Wilson in New York, Zach Wilson just has incredible, he's probably the most talented kid in the draft class. And he has special feel for throwing the football. The most talented thrower in the class is Zach Wilson. Trey Lance is going to the best situation, best tight end play, best play caller. The running game is exceptional out there. The division is a little bit tougher, but so is the AFC East. The AFC East is very tough. Justin Fields is going to the worst situation possible. He's going to a coach in Matt Nagy that is absolutely atrocious. I mean, Matt Nagy in that game against New Orleans, he did not develop Mitchell Trubisky into a quarterback. Everybody blames Mitchell Trubisky, but Mitchell Trubisky had a really good sophomore season, and then Mitchell Trubisky did not progress under Matt Nagy. Matt Nagy also had Anthony Miller. Anthony Miller was not that good with Matt Nagy. Anthony Miller was a stud at Memphis. You look at David Montgomery. Montgomery gets hurt every year, and he hasn't been the same player that he was at Iowa State. So Matt Nagy is an absolutely awful head coach. Matt Nagy is a guy that let the Eagles into the playoffs that one year when he should have let the Vikings into that year. He was carried by Vic Fangio and Khalil Mack in that defense. He's a terrible offensive coordinator and play caller. I mean, he cannot call offense. He does not develop wide receivers whatsoever. I mean, they had Allen Robinson there. He was all right under Matt Nagy, but the offense is a joke. The offensive line is actually really good. He is not making it work. And, you know, you have the guy for, you have Daniels, you have Cody White here from Kansas State. I mean, you have a lot of really good guys on that offensive line. You have Leno Jr., you know, who could really have good games. So I look at Justin Fields, and again, I think that Justin Fields in college, first of all, he was amazing in college, so you can't knock his performance that much. But I just believe that Ryan Day, you had a lot of screen passes. The offensive line would really protect. I don't believe Justin's that good of an improviser. I mean, Justin Fields, yeah, he can run a fast 40 time, but is Justin Fields, when play breaks down, is he going to make something happen? I think Zach Wilson does a good job of improvising. Now, Zach had all the time in the world to throw the ball. Trevor Lawrence is decent, but he's had no adversity. So then you look at the guys that can really improvise in this class. I think Mac Jones certainly knows that when the pocket breaks down, he knows how to get out of plays and make plays happen. I think Trey Lance, you look at his pro day, he was incredibly special. You look at him leading the Bison to championships. I just said that it wasn't that impressive. Even Easton Stick did it. But at the same time, you know, Trey Lance, again, big arm, seems like a smart kid, you know, had to work hard, comes from a small town, the chip on the shoulder is there, very kind person, very kind in these interviews, very impressive, he speaks very clearly, so his interviewing is absolutely exceptional, and he checks every box probably from the North Dakota State organization and the North Dakota State team. So that's important. But again, when else are you going to have somebody not check a box? I mean, you have to go dig deep to find reasons. And I guess that's why the scouts are out there all the time. So you look at Trey Lance, and it's going to be fascinating with Shanahan. It absolutely can fail, actually. But I look at Mac Jones in New England, and I like this fit just about better than any quarterback, because I love what he can do in the McDaniels offense. I love him with Geno Smith. I really like him with Hunter Henry. You know, Cam Newton has experience being the best player in the whole league, winning a most valuable player award, being the number one draft pick. I mean, Cam Newton's been through all that stuff, and Mac Jones is going to learn the game from Cam Newton. And Cam is a guy that actually in New England, you might think that he doesn't fit New England because he wears fancy clothes. But Cam Newton actually did a nice job last year of kind of fitting in there. And even though his play wasn't that great, I think that him and Stidham, I think Stidham's also a really good guy to have in the quarterback room. I think it's going to be a really fun quarterback room. And this whole team, I'm excited to see about the running backs like Damian Harris and Sony Michel. I want to see Michel develop. I want to see N'Keal Harry really develop with Bill Belichick and this offense. I want to see Aguilar. Kendrick Bourne's going to be fascinating, getting him from the 49ers to Patriots, see something in him. And the fact that Mac Jones, I mean, the fact that the Bears wouldn't take Mac Jones, I think Mac Jones is just a better release than Justin Fields. He's just as good outside of the pocket as Justin, has better touch on the football, can make more throws, make more a variety of more different level throws, throws with more touch. I think Mac Jones is going to be a phenomenal quarterback. And for the 49ers at three, for draft Twitter to somehow think that going 12 spots later, you're somehow not going to be a good quarterback in the NFL, I think is ridiculous. And people are acting like the ninth pick in this draft, Justin Fields, is going to be an exceptional quarterback, when I think that Mac Jones is going to be just as good of a quarterback in New England. Now, could Mac Jones have done it in Jacksonville? It always is a combination, but I believe that Mac is going to have more success in the NFL than Trevor Lawrence. Trevor Lawrence might make Pro Bowls and so forth, but Mac is going to win in New England. He's going to win with Belichick, but he's also going to win because he's an exceptional player. And these two guys together, now you gave Bill Belichick, the NFL and the Bears allowed Bill Belichick to now get an absolute gem in Mac Jones. I don't even know that he knows how good Mac Jones is. I'm just incredibly impressed with this landing spot. I'm happy for Mac Jones. I think Mac Jones has taken so much crap from every single media outlet in the offseason. And Mac Jones has been through the ringer in this. Nobody likes Mac Jones. They all make fun of him because of his weight. Everybody has Justin Fields and Lance ahead of Mac Jones. And then somehow, because Bill Belichick drafts him, somehow that's the only reason that he's not completely getting made fun of and tossed to the wolves. I mean, this guy had an amazing college football season. He's going to be a better quarterback in the league than Joe Burrow. If I can have Joe Burrow or Mac Jones, I'm taking Mac Jones every day of the week. Bigger arm, better processor, just quicker, more accurate. I'm taking Mac Jones all every day of the week, including the day that you play football on Sunday. I mean, I believe Mac Jones is better than Joe Burrow. I believe that he's an exceptional quarterback. The only quarterback that I'd maybe look at taking over him might be Zach Wilson based on talent alone. I think Mac is also safer than Trey Lance in this process. Would I take Lawrence? I don't think Lawrence can read the defenses as well as Mac can. The football IQ with Lawrence, I think Lawrence came from a really simple system. I think Mac's going to outwork these guys just from what I see. And that's just my opinion. You know, I believe that Mac's been for more adversity than Lawrence. And, you know, this guy's story is special. But also the throws he makes, his throwing motion, I think he has Hall of Fame written all over him. And, you know, I hope that Mac can get rid of the ball fast enough so he doesn't have to elude the pocket. I hope that he could stay in there. I hope that his quick release works at the National Football League. And I hope that he makes really smart decisions, continues to even improve his arm strength. And I hope that McDaniels can scheme up some really good simple throws for Mac Jones. They could run the ball a little bit. I'm really excited to see this happen. Now, Trey Lance does have the talent to be really good. The quarterbacks that are going to be good in this draft class, it's going to be Kellen Mond, it's going to be Mac Jones, and then Trey Lance and Zach Wilson are up in the air just because of their situations and their circumstances. I mean, Zach Wilson in New York, he hasn't really had the circumstance in the system. I mean, I'm worried about Zach Wilson in New York because who has succeeded in New York? And then Trey Lance is a boomer bust player. If he's a bust, he's not going to be able to hit the middle of the field. He's going to get hurt maybe if they try to incorporate him in run game. Him and Shanahan are not going to get along on an exceptional level. I think that Mac in New England is the safest bet to work. Mac knows Belichick. He knows pro-style systems. He can make the throws. It's just a matter of, again, he's going to fail if his limitations, if he gets sacked too much, if he can't read, if he can't make the plays. But I think that Mac can be, I think that he could be elite. I need him to be better than Kirk Cousins. I need him to just, you know, be a little more decisive, and he at least has a height advantage over Kirk Cousins, and I'm really rooting for Mac, and I never thought I'd root for the Patriots, but they're the total underdog now. Brady left that team, you know, Bill Belichick got absolutely stomped out by the Buffalo Bills, and now you look at Mac Jones, this overweight kid from Alabama that absolutely got dragged by the 49ers and by all the media, and everybody teases Mac at every step of the way, just say he's a pocket passer, the pocket passer is dead, you can't hang in the pocket and make throws, he's so overweight. He was only good because of Devontae Smith. He was only good because of Alabama. Even A.J. McCarron could play at Alabama. It's not going to translate to this level. He's never going to be a star player. He's not worthy of being a top three pick. You can maybe get him in the middle of the first round because he's an average quarterback, going to be an average NFL player. That is the message with Mac Jones, okay? That is what people are saying. Just like with Justin Herbert, they said that he would not work at all. He was a bust from Oregon. He just looked the part because of the pro day. That's what has been said about these guys. And when guys get dragged through this process, I absolutely love it. I kind of personally like guys kind of responding to criticism and showing up and shutting up the haters and the critics is most of the time, 95% of the time, that's really fun to watch, or at least very respectable. All right, guys, I enjoyed doing this video. Thanks for hanging with this channel. Who knows what kind of name we're going to have going forward, but just hope you enjoy watching my content, and you can always call me the Rover. I don't really care. But just changing the name of this will probably allow for more topics, more chatter, and more discussion. So Bill Belichick and Mac Jones. How does Mac compare to the other quarterbacks taken in the first round? I kind of tackled that here in this video, kind of explaining all of my thoughts and the thought process revolving the first round quarterbacks.